Hi guys, this is Balazs from Racing Brick. I'm sure you're surprised to see me here. I'm usually on the other side of the camera. The Powered Up app received an update a few days ago, and there are so many things I want to talk about. I thought I would switch format, and instead of subtitles, I will talk you through the details. I would also love to hear your feedback, whether you like this new format or not. Shall I do this more often, or probably never again? So please leave a comment below, and let's get started. The Powered Up app received an update a few days ago. I updated the iPad to see the new features, but left my Android phone on the previous version so I can show you the differences. As you can see, the iPad is updated to 2.4.0, that's the latest version, and the phone is still on 2.2.0. To clarify things at the very beginning, this is not the big update that we were waiting for the Powered Up app. There are some new features, but not the ones that we were really waiting for. So there's no support yet for the Technic hub. There's no proper support for the L and XL motors. There's no multi-hub support, and there's still no real customizable interface. So let's see what we did receive actually. There's a new controller interface called Race Car. It is possible to combine blocks to composite blocks. There's a new advanced settings panel. It's possible to disable Auto Connect, and it is possible to set a default palette level. This is the new advanced settings panel. It is possible to turn off Auto Connect, which means the app won't automatically connect to the hub, which is turned on. You need to tap on it in the menu. And the default palette level is the default complexity for a new application. The biggest new feature is on the second screen. As you can see on the previous version, there was one controller interface with the two sliders and three buttons. And now in the new version, there is a new controller interface with a joystick and more buttons and graphics. If you open the new controller on the iPad, you can see that something is wrong. The elements are not properly scaled, so properly it was not prepared to be used on an iPad. I will update the Android version in a minute, and I will show you how it is supposed to look like. Before updating the app, let's see what are the differences between the control blocks. So in the basic blocks, everything is pretty much the same. Among the motor controllers, there is a new one that belongs to the new control interface. The others are again the same. Here there are also some new control elements corresponding to the new control interface. At the end, we got the new composite blocks, which are basically multiple commands combined into a single program block. This one can be familiar from the Boost application. I quickly updated the Android version to show you how the control interface is really supposed to look like. Hopefully, the iOS version will be corrected soon to have a properly scaled interface element. Otherwise, the program blocks behind them are absolutely the same. So it would be good to have a proper version on the iPad because it's much easier to edit on a bigger screen. Let's see what the new control interface does actually. Based on my tests, it only works with the simple M motors from the Batmobile. There's a joystick there, but this joystick apparently only controls forward and backwards motion. So if we try to turn, nothing happens. It is possible to change the direction of the motors, so depending on the installation, they can run in the same direction or they can run reversed. But again, it only affects forwards and backwards motion. Besides the different sound effects, the coolest new function is this boost or nitro button. By default, the throttle is limited to 80%. And with the press of this button, we can use the full 100%. Of course, it runs out, so it needs some time to recharge. I think it's a cool play function. If we take a closer look at the controls, you can see that if we try to turn with the joystick slightly, the wheels on one side will run faster than on the other side. So it is actually possible to use it for steering. But it's nowhere near as effective as the two slider interface that was available previously. So the Batmobile can turn, but very slightly. For me, it seems that this new control interface was designed to this 2M motor setup. It does not seem to work with any other motor types. So either the L motor or the Boost M motor or even the XL motor, I can plug them in, but nothing works. So obviously it is possible to use a different control setup. So I removed the default block and I assigned the simple motor controller to port A and the simple steering setup to port B. So the XL motor is used for driving and the L motor is used here for steering. So as you can see, it sort of works. The acceleration works better than the steering. The steering is very, very glitchy, does not follow the commands. Another problem with the steering is the lack of absolute positioning. The central position zero here is the position where the motor is turned on. So unlike the Control Plus app, there is no calibration, there is no possibility to set a zero in the application. The central position will be always the position when we turn it on. So it is not properly usable to control a remote controlled car. So on top of this, it is clearly visible that the L and XL motors need additional support in the application. It happens frequently with me that in the Android app, the motor control gets stuck. So as you can see, I don't touch the joystick and the motor still runs. So besides the previous bugs, there are still many little issues in the application. For example, here you can see that I have a simple M motor and a boost M motor. If I select port A and port B, they both work, but the port selection AB does not work at all. Also, it is difficult for the first sight to differentiate between the two controllers. The top one can control both motors, the bottom one can only control the boost M motor because that one has an encoder. So anyway, the motors are not that easy to differentiate and to understand the main differences. So the simple medium linear motor has only speed control. The medium linear motor from the boost set and the move hub, the two internal motors have speed control and also relative positioning. The L motor and the XL motor from the Technic set has speed control and also absolute positioning, which means they can be used as servo. To sum it up, I still like the powered up system and I'm always trying to be the glass is half full type of guy, but with these updates I'm getting more and more worried. Now we received an update with a new control interface but with very little information and it doesn't seem to work properly, or at least I was not able to figure out how to use it properly. The app and the blocks would desperately need some additional information in the app and also possibly some tutorials about their usage on LEGO's webpage. The Boost app at least has some tooltips for their blocks. I understand that it requires some effort to translate these to all languages, but without them, LEGO customers, especially kids, won't really understand how to use the app. There are several different types of blocks available. Some work with all motors, some only with certain motors. At this point, it is very difficult to figure out which one works with which for an average user. Honestly, I don't see how this will turn into a simple customizable interface. In its current format, it is way more complex than it should be for an average user. Kids and their parents who are not into boost level coding will be intimidated if they want to change something from the default settings, and suddenly they face this Super Mario level kind of view with all the complexity of the different colored blocks and loops and everything. I really like the possibility for this level of customization, but there definitely should be a more simple way to do it, and not only by hiding certain blocks. With power functions connecting motors to a certain port was very simple and visible, although with the two type of remotes it was fairly limited. Now that we can have joysticks, buttons, sliders, anything, there really should be a way to simply assign them to a specific port of a specific hub without the need of any visual coding. So let's wait and see what the next powered up update will bring us. Hopefully it will be better than this one. Until then, I will still stick to Brick Controller 2 because that one simply works for me. Controlling power functions powered up, who is anything. I'm almost finished with a project that will be hopefully very useful for you. It will be published in the next few days, so make sure to subscribe and tap on the notification bell. Thanks for watching, and please let me know in the comments what do you think about this new format. See you next time.